A waterfall chart shows a running total as values are added or subtracted. It's useful for understanding what additions and subtractions were made to a value to get it to its current value. In this example, we have income statements for the year ended 2023 and the year ended 2024. The values in column D come from subtracting the 2023 values from the 2024 values. If the value was higher in 2023 than in 2024, the value is negative. The next step is to extrapolate the data you want to highlight in your chart. This is the data I will feed into the waterfall chart. Let's take a moment to review the data we will be using. The values shown in red will be decreases. They increased in amount from 2023 to 2024, but they decrease the net income. Let's first look at sales. We had an increase in sales of $30,000 from 2023 to 2024. The sales returns and allowances also increased. But this increase means a decrease in our sales, so we will use a negative 1,090. The sales minus the sales returns gives us a net sales of 28,910. The cost of goods increased by 12,775. This value is made negative because it decreases our net income. Net sales minus the cost of goods sold gives us the gross profit. The operating expenses increased by $875, so that is a decrease to our net income. The gross profit minus the operating expenses gives us a net income before tax of $15,260. Our income tax increased by $323, so that is a negative for our net income. The net income before tax minus the income tax gives us our net income after tax. I will now create the chart. I will first select the extrapolated data. I will click on the Ribbons Insert tab. I will click on the dialog box in the Charts group. In the Recommended Charts, I will click on the Waterfall Chart. I will click on the OK button. The Waterfall Chart shows positive values in blue and negative values in orange. We don't currently have any totals, but we will modify our chart to show them. Looking at the data, we can see that the net income after tax is $14,937. However, looking at the chart's vertical axis, we can see that net income after taxes is at the 90,000 line. The reason this has happened is because some of our values are actually totals. For example, net sales is a total of sales minus sales returns. The chart shows sales at 30,000, then our income decreases by 1,090. But then we add an additional 28,910 for net sales, which is not what we want. We need to tell Excel which of our values are computed totals. I will click on the net sales bar, which is called a data point. All of the data points are selected. I will click on the net sales data point again. Now, the other data points are dimmed. I will right-click on the net sales data point, then select Format Data Point. The Format Data Point pane is displayed on the right side of the spreadsheet. I will change the gap width to 36% to decrease the width between the data points. I will check Set as Total. You can see that net sales has a value of 28,910, and it now matches with the vertical axis. I will click on the gross profit data point, then check set as total. I will click on the net income before tax data point, then check set as total. I will click on the net income after tax data point, and then check set as total. I will click anywhere outside of the chart to deselect it. The net income after tax of $14,937 matches with the vertical axis and the income statement. We can now easily see what affected the changes between the 2023 and 2024 income statements. Sales increased net income after taxes by $30,000. Sales returns decreased net income after taxes by $1,090. Cost of goods sold decreased net income after taxes by $12,775. Operating expenses decreased net income after taxes by $875. Income tax decreased net income after taxes by $323. Click on the chart title. Change the chart title to Analysis of Changes from 2023 to 2024 Income Statements. I will give the data points a more colorful look by clicking on the Chart Design tab and then picking a different color theme from the Change Colors button. Now for a nifty trick. You will probably want to have a dashboard where you can store all of your analysis for each year so that you can quickly make comparisons. You will need to use Excel's little-known camera tool to do this. You should add the camera tool to your quick access toolbar so that it is always quickly available. You can add the camera tool by right-clicking on the quick access toolbar, then selecting Customize Quick Access Toolbar. The Excel Options dialog box opens. Select Commands Not in the Ribbon. Select Camera. Click on the Add button. Click on the OK button. The camera now appears on the Quick Access toolbar. You could select the cells around all of the data and the chart and then take a picture of it. I will just take a picture of the graph itself. If you do not want cell lines, you can fill in the space with white. Now, click on the camera. A picture has been taken of the selected area. Click where you want the image to appear. Now, right-click on it and select Save as Picture. I will delete the picture from the worksheet. Now that I have the picture I want, I can place it in a note on another worksheet or workbook with a link back to where the data is. I will create a new worksheet. I will right-click on a cell and then select New Note. You will want to move your cursor on the edge of the note until it is four arrows. Now you can right-click on it and then select Format Comment. Click on the Colors and Lines tab. click on the down arrow for colors, and then select Fill Effects. Click on the Picture tab. Click on the Select Picture button. If you stored the picture on your computer, select From a File. Select the file you saved. Be sure to check Lock Picture Aspect Ratio. Now, you can make it whatever size you want. Right-click on the Note cell, and then select Show Hide Note. Now the image will only appear when you move your cursor over it. I will right-click on the Note cell and select Link. I will select Income Statements 2023 and 2024. You can see how you could easily archive all your charts and other data on one worksheet with links to other worksheets or workbooks. I will click on the link to take me back to the original data. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.